Marty is back, dude. Marty is back.
Well, I mean, he never left, but yeah, the Irishman is awesome. I should have just started off with that, but what do you expect with a movie directed by Scorsese and starring Robert De Niro, Joe Pesci, Al Pacino, and Ray Romano? While I still think Silence is Scorsese's best in recent memory, second only to Can of Comedy being my absolute favorite Scorsese movie, The Irishman is a return to form for the gangster genre. A genre that, I'm gonna be honest, I'm not really a big fan of. If anything, it's probably my least favorite genre. They usually bore me with a couple of exceptions. The Irishman, however, is anything but boring. One of my favorite aspects of The Irishman is just the non-stop energy going around. Everyone and everything is always loud and in your face. The dialogue here is so quick and sharp, there's never a line that felt unnecessary or out of character. The characters all have this ego to them. They all want to be the most important, also simultaneously being the most feared. They almost always talk over each other to assert their dominance to a point where you do actually feel afraid of these characters. Martin Scorsese has always had a reputation of coughing up great movies well into his 70s. He's never made a movie that sucked. I mean, I haven't seen everything, I wouldn't know, but Scorsese knows how to make characters engaging and he knows how to have this non-stop energy in a way that never feels forced. Even his less energetic movies like Silence are some of the most engaging movies that I can think of. He always gets you to think long after the movie is over, and even if you don't like the movie for whatever reason, it still probably won't ever leave your mind. The Irishman is one of those movies. It's both energetic and engaging. Not in the way something like Goodfellas is, where the tension is non-stop. The Irishman takes its time to develop its characters, and even though they're pretty shitty people, you somehow like them in the end. De Niro plays a man who could not only snap if you crossed him the wrong way, but would have no problem killing you on the spot. If he thinks you should go, you would have already been gone. De Niro is able to capture that menacing trait so well. He's unpredictable and you always have a clue about how far he'll go, but he'll always go a few steps further than what you expect. Pesci, welcome back, my man. As soon as he appeared on screen after years of retirement, my audience cheered, and I was right there with him. Much like De Niro, Pesci plays a man who doesn't fuck around. Throughout his performance, he seems like a man who has a good heart, but he could also snap at any moment. And he, much like De Niro, is very intimidating. Al Pacino, though, stole the entire movie. He's always talking and always taking the spotlight from others, and he knows how to say this dialogue like rapid fire. He never misses a beat, and you can't take your eyes off of him. He just has this commanding presence.
Always charge a guy with a gun. With a knife, you run away. So you charge with a gun, with a knife, you run.
The de-aging was something that was worrying me, because I thought it was going to look very Uncanny Valley, and I have to admit the first couple of scenes they used it didn't look great. It kind of looked like they were made of plastic, but after some time, it got significantly better. It was a really great use of the effect for the most part. The 3.5 hour runtime also bothered me a little, as it did drag a little bit and some scenes were less interesting than others. And again, gangster movies, not my thing, so I can only be interested in gangster shit for so long. Yeah, it didn't really need to be 3.5 hours long, but then again, nothing really felt like wasted time. It's just so satisfying to see all these legends back in another movie, and it was absolutely worth it, as this is one of the best of the year. It's consistently engaging, funny, and the last 30 or so minutes are surprisingly pretty cathartic and has one of my favorite final shots of the entire year. I just wish that we didn't have to wait 3.5 hours to get to that, but everything else was very entertaining and engaging. It was all worth it, and please see this in the theater.